Brian Laundrie's parents are back in their Northport home tonight after taking a short trip to mourn the loss of their son in private. Tonight, Northport police tell NBC2 the mistakes they made in Laundrie's case would not have kept him alive. Thanks for counting on NBC2. I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. Police spokesman Josh Taylor tells NBC2 they thought they saw Gabby Petito's fiance return home before he was reported missing. It turns out it was his mother wearing a baseball cap.
We put video of Roberta and Brian side by side so you can see the mother and son. NBC2's Samantha Servin is live at the home after talking to police about this mistake in the investigation.
Josh Taylor says they're sharing this now because they want the people to better understand why they thought Brian was here at home. Here's the timeline. Gabby Petito was reported missing September 11th, 11 days after her fiancé, Brian Laundrie, returns to his Northport home in her van. On September 13th, Brian goes for a hike and never returns. 2 days later, his mother brings the silver Mustang he took to the Myakkahatchee back home. This is where the mess-up occurred. Police say they thought Brian returned home that day, but it was actually Roberta Laundrie in a baseball cap. The next day...
Do you know where Brian Laundrie is right now?
Yes.
Police Chief Todd Garrison made that statement because they thought Brian had returned home the day before. It wasn't until Friday evening when police came inside the Laundrie home for the first time, only to find out the person of interest in Gabby's case was also gone without a trace. Josh Taylor says the mishap was a direct result of the lack of cooperation from the Laundrie family, saying, quote, "This misidentification did not have a big impact on costs and the investigation. Other than confusion, it likely changed nothing. There is a very good possibility that Brian was already deceased. He still needed to be found," end quote. Once their son went missing, Chris and Roberta Laundrie started to cooperate, but kept quiet about the other half of the investigation.
They just simply haven't given information when it comes to anything they may have known about Gabby and her death and the potential for Brian's involvement.
Northport is owning up to their mistakes. Josh Taylor says no case is perfect.
Samantha, Northport police are also addressing rumors that perhaps remains found in the Carlton Reserve are not Brian.
Yeah, so they are addressing that today with hearing a lot of rumors flying around about DNA not matching. And the medical examiner's office is sharing a statement saying they haven't even done DNA testing yet. The remains were confirmed to be Brian's using dental records. Once the medical examiner's examination is complete, then DNA testing will be done. Live in Northport, Samantha Servin, NBC2.
Samantha.